Welcome back. This is an Alex homework video on predicting the ions formed by common main group elements. Main group is also called representative elements, and this is groups, the first two columns and the last six columns. Okay, so what we would call A's, group 1A, group 2A, group 3A through 8A. Before this, any of this makes sense, there is kind of a underlying property in chemistry, or underlying rule, I suppose, in chemistry, that all elements are trying to be as stable as they can be. Something will fall off the shelf if it's unstable. It's trying to become more stable. A rock will fall downhill because it's unstable at the top. If it were stable, it wouldn't fall. Something stable doesn't fall, it only falls when it's unstable. And so it will roll and continue to roll until it's stable. Now it'll either roll to the bottom of the hill and stop, or it'll land on a cliff or some kind of some sticky out place to where it can stop and not continue to move, but it's actually trying to be stable. In elements, the most stable group is group 8A, the noble gases. The noble gases have all of their valence shells full. So the first period, it's going to have two, and it's full. So hydrogen and helium are full. Helium is very stable. In the other periods, period two and following, all of those will be stable when they have eight. And this is called the octet rule. All elements will tend to react in some ways, either stealing electrons or sharing electrons or some other way in order to become more stable than they were normally. So they're trying to become like the noble gases. Well, that's a really easy clue when you're trying to find out the ions. What will they do? Will they give away electrons? Well, they will if that will get them to have the same valence shell as a noble gas. Will they steal electrons? They will if it's easier for them to get a noble gas configuration if they can steal. All right, so if you can look at a periodic table, this will help you. You should always have a periodic table when you're doing your homework all the time. It's in the front of your book. All right, so it will be the closest one. So if you have something to the left of the periodic table, and it gives away an electron, well, then that the valence electron is, there's one, let's say it's in the first group, the first group, it's like hydrogen group. It has one valence electron. If it gives that electron away, gets it stolen, well, then the inside shell becomes the outside shell, because the only shell was that one electron, and when it was stolen, that valence shell goes away, and the inside shell becomes the outside shell, and now it's full. So anything in group one would give away an electron and have the configuration of the previous row, the same electron configuration of the noble gas of the previous row. So if you're looking, say, at sodium number 11, if it gives away a valence electron, it becomes the same valence fill as neon. And neon's very stable. So when sodium gives away something, it becomes positive one. Anything close to the group 8 is going to steal to become more like. So if it's in group 6, it's going to steal 2 to be like group 8, and it becomes negative 2. If it's 1 away from group 8, it's going to steal 1 and become negative, the same configuration as the noble gas. So how close can it be? If it's closer to give away and go and be to the previous shell, then it will do that and become positive cations. If it's closer to group 8 to steal and become like the one on the same row as it, same period, then it'll do that. So look at scandium. Scandium is in group, it's in the fourth row on the periodic table. We'll find out that it's actually in the third shell, but it's in group the fourth row, scandium. And scandium, so it's in 1B, or the third one across. If it's trying to give away to get to have the same configuration as argon in the previous row, it would give away three. If it gave away one, it would be like calcium. If it gave away two, it would become like potassium. If it gave away three, it would be like argon, and argon is stable. So it will do that. And so scandium, the symbol is scandium 3+. It's one of the choices. There's actually more, but scandium 3+. It's positive, so therefore it is a cation. All right, so they did this one for us. What would oxygen be? Look at a periodic table. Oxygen is in group 6. It wants to be like group 8. So if it wants to be like neon, which is in group 8, it needs 8 in its outer shell. It only has 6 in its outer shell. It's going to steal 2. And if it steals 2, it's negative, becomes an anion. Well, what's it going to look like? Well, it's still oxygen, but it's stolen 2 electrons, so it's going to be O2 negative. Okay, I hope this is starting to click. What about chlorine? Chlorine is in group 7. It's 1 away from group 8. So if it's 1 away from group 8, it's going to steal 1 to be like group 8, so it'll be like argon. But if it steals 1, first of all, it's negative, it'll be an anion. But what will it look like? It's going to look like Cl, 1 negative. Okay, so you don't write 1 negative, you just write the negative there. Okay, what about strontium? Okay, strontium is Sr. What group is it in? It's in group 2a. All right, so group 2a has 2 valence electrons. It's either going to have to steal 6 and become negative 6, or give away those 2 and become positive 2. Either way, it's going to have a configuration equal to a noble gas. Well, it's easier to give away 2 and become 2+, than it is to steal 6 and become 6 negative. So this one is positive. It's a cation, and its symbol is Sr2+. Last one, lithium. Lithium is Li. Is in group 1. So in order to get like group 8, it's either going to give away the one it has and be like the group 8 in the previous row, previous period, or it's going to steal 7 in order to get 8 and become negative 7. Well, the chances of getting negative 7 is really impossible, so it's going to give away 1, and that would be positive, and so it's a cation. So anything on the left side of the periodic table, if it becomes an ion, is going to become positive. Anything on the right is going to become negative and become an anion. Longest video so far. I hope this helps you.